Welcome to Urine Formation Step 2, Tubular Reabsorption. In this step, we are looking at substances moving out of the tubules of the nephron and being reabsorbed into the blood of the peritubular capillary network. The tubules of the nephron involved are the proximal convoluted tubule, or PCT, and the loop of the nephron. During glomerular filtration, too many substances were pushed out of the blood and into the glomerular capsule, that tubule of the nephron. Recall that the molecules removed were nitrogenous wastes, nutrients, salts, and water. Now, too many substances are filtered out, and some must be returned into the blood. The nephron needs to filter out nitrogenous waste or excess water and salts. However, the body needs to reabsorb nutrients and necessary water and salts and have them return to the bloodstream. Let's take a closer look at the process. The structure of the PCT is built to allow substances to be reabsorbed into the blood. It is formed of a single layer of cuboidal epithelial cells that contain many microvilli. Recall that microvilli are small finger-like extensions built to allow for reabsorption. The microvilli allow for reabsorption of nutrients, most water, and required salts. So as the filtrate is traveling in the proximal convoluted tubule, nutrients, water, and salts will leave the PCT and move into the blood of the peritubular capillary network. The filtrate itself continues to flow in the PCT, but those substances are moved into the blood. The loop of the nephron also plays a role in reabsorption. As the filtrate goes down the descending loop of the nephron, water will be reabsorbed. As the filtrate then travels up the ascending loop, salt will be reabsorbed. In this diagram, we can see a little bit of the substances outlined when we look at the loop of the nephron. As the loop of the nephron enters the renal medulla, so it goes from the renal cortex here into the renal medulla, there is an increasing solute concentration. The further into the medulla the loop goes, the higher that concentration is. This means that water molecules are going to leave the tubule, as we see here, through osmosis, as there is a lower concentration of water outside the tubule than inside the tubule. Now you'll also notice as the nephron loop comes down, it gets very thin here, and it continues to remain thin until it gets thicker as it ascends. This is very important. At this point, the loop of the nephron is impermeable to water, which means no water can leave the tubule of the nephron at this point. However, you'll notice that salts do leave the nephron. At the bottom of the loop, through diffusion, salt will move passively out of the loop, and then at this point, as it moves up the ascending loop of nephron, salt is actively transported out of the nephron tubule. The filtrate at this point, when we get to the top of the loop of the nephron, is now called tubular filtrate. To summarize, tubular reabsorption involves the PCT or proximal convoluted tubule as well as the loop of the nephron. It also involves blood vessels, peritubular capillary network, which we can see around those tubules. Nutrients, water, and salts are reabsorbed from the proximal convoluted tubule, and a loop of the nephron into the peritubular capillary network.